sleepy blue ocean. You fill up my senses, come fill me again. Come let me love you, let me give my life to you. Let me drown in your laughter, let me die in your
Welcome. Marriage is a beautiful and complex thing, joining two souls, two hearts as one. Today, we take in celebrating the beginning of Evett and Hayden's journey together. I'm William Harvey, father of the bride, and I'd like to thank you all for sharing in this special day. I would like to thank Sarah Barton for a beautiful wedding ceremony. Thank you, Sarah. Sarah is the chaplain at Pepperdine University, where Hayden and Evett first met day one of freshman year. She is a confidant and a close friend. I'd especially like to welcome Evett into our family. As parents, all you want is to see your children happy. So we are beyond thrilled to see how happy our daughter is when she's with Evett. She was born in the spring of 97. She was sent straight here from up in heaven. She's our little angel, sure as can be. And that's why we named her Hayden Harvey. Hayden, Hayden Harvey, queen of the Harvey household. My beautiful wife, Kathy, wrote that little ditty when Hayden was just a little baby. You would think giving a little girl the title of queen would be asking for trouble. But anybody that knows Hayden knows that she is the most kind, sensitive, and caring, empathetic person you could ever meet. When Hayden was 9 years old, she called family and friends and threw us a surprise anniversary party. Now, not many people at that young age could pull off a surprise that big. What's astonishing is that people actually came. And when I asked them, why would you trust a 9-year-old? They said, well, it's Hayden. So, and a lot of those people are here in the room today, so It was a wonderful party that she threw. And when she was 10, she started Give Hope a Chance, a charity organization that sent food and goods to the poorest underprivileged children of Africa. And back here at home, she started the Denver Shoe Crew. She collected new shoes for the Colorado Coalition for the Homeless. She was always giving of herself to help others, and that makes me very proud. From the first moment I first held her in the hospital, I knew she would always be my little angel butt. But I taught her how to tie her shoes, ride a bike, cast a fishing rod. We would go on long nature walks where it turns out she turned out to be a true badass. And I know she likes that. She quickly developed a love of the great outdoors, something that her and Evett share to this day. Evett, I couldn't be happier than I am today, knowing that the rest of our lives into perpetuity, that she has you to be her wonderful, amazing partner. The two of you fit together like a perfect puzzle. I'm so happy to call you my son-in-law. I would like to thank Evett's parents and family for all the help and generosity in planning the Evett and Hayden wedding. We're so happy to join our families together. I can see by the way Evett treats my little baby girl that you raised a perfect gentleman. He is such an outstanding man and deserves to be treated like a king. And he just married the queen of the Harvey household. Kathy, my love, we started this journey 25 years ago when you shouted out in glee, "I have a daughter!" And it was exactly like that too. Hayden is a testament to your devotion as a mother. It's been a hell of a ride, and we made it, and it's freaking wonderful. Everyone, please stand, and join me in a toast to Hayden and Evett. I just saw a shooting star. You can wish upon it. Please share the wish you made, but you can keep no secrets. We know you wished for everlasting love. Now go out and make it. Cheers.
Cheers.
Love you. Now Peter's going to come up and talk.
Welcome. Hello, I'm Evett's dad. Very proud. Be nice, pay attention, and be there for each other always. I would like to thank all of you for being at this very special event. There's so much love and attention to every detail. Hayden and Evett, each of you have made a tremendous amount of time and energy planning and pulling this all together. And thank you, Hayden, because I know that while Evett is completely invested, he does his best possible work at the last possible moment. You know this, and you accept this about him. I cannot tell you how many times he waited until 11:59 to make the final edit to submit those English papers to Mrs. McLaughlin. These are things you know about Evett and you accept him. I've been immensely proud of Evett because I know that he is a kind and generous person. I'm known around Durango as, "Oh, you're Evett's dad." And it's always followed by a kind and wonderful story about Evett's kindness or leadership or generosity. Evett has made it very easy, mostly. And Hayden, this you have to look forward to. But another thing, Hayden, that you know and you accept about Evett, he has a lucky wallet. Or should I say, he's lucky to have a wallet. I just recounted this to Evett, and he admitted that he has material ripe for a children's book. Evett and the return of his amazing wallet. One chapter, and yes, this is a chapter book. One time, Evett called me on the way to the Albuquerque airport. I was in Durango, about 3.5 hours away. Dad, I can't find my wallet. I look, yes, it's here in Durango. About 20 minutes later, he's on the plane to Denver. He says, yeah, I made it through TSA without any ID. Let me tell you, this is a person who has been screened by national security, despite the fact that during his interview, he showed up at the desk and they said, okay, Evett, nice to meet you. The first thing we need is your driver's license. Evett pulled out his lucky wallet. No driver's license. He was distracted through the rest of the interview, looking like, where could my driver's license be? Didn't it show up 2 weeks later, clipped under the windshield wiper of his car? No note, no description. It just showed back up. So this is the person we're trusting with national security. And again, we can all do this. I've done it. So when Evett was heading to Scotland with the Pepperdine Theater Troupe, he was asked to scan and submit the important documents before leaving for the flight. So doing his best work, at the last possible moment, he scanned his documents, leaving his driver's license on the scanner. He gets to the airport. No big deal. We're going to Scotland. I don't need my driver's license. But now he only has one form of ID to get into the pubs because he's 18. So again, no problem. He takes out his passport. He puts it in his back pocket. He walks 8 to 10 blocks, kind of a circuitous route to the pub. Gets there. No wallet or no passport. Didn't his flatmate Will leave about 20 minutes later and again walk a random route, and crossing an intersection or a crossroad, he sees a passport, leans over and picks it up, opens it, and it's a picture of Evett. So it was returned again amazingly. And the list goes on. Let's see. And there's more. Campus security at Pepperdine returned his ID and keys more than one occasion. Leo Carrillo State Park Ranger hand-delivered his wallet to campus after a camping trip. Even the elephant seals of Piedras Blancas State Park took a break from their mating ritual to anonymously send a package to Evett back at Pepperdine with his wallet. So let me ask you, if any of you have more stories, get together with me this weekend. We will do this, and this may be Hayden's next masterpiece. And Hayden, you know this about the one you have chosen. You may want to hang onto your documents in Greece to avoid adding to the future bestseller. Yeah,
yeah. We already had our passports for like 3 weeks.
That's good. You know this. And Evett, you know that Hayden attracts adventure. She attracts interesting people and often gets a job offer wherever she goes. So I wouldn't be surprised if she leaves tonight with one or two job offers, including the wedding planner, after the great effort that she has put into this event. But be on guard in Greece. She may get a job or some interesting. So Hayden, I graciously and enthusiastically welcomed you to our family. This past Sunday, Father's Day, Hayden texted me and said, "Happy Father's Day. I can't wait to have you as my father-in-law. I hope it was a great day. This brought tears to my eyes, and Hayden, I'm so happy to finally have you as my daughter-in-law. So I hope it's the best day ever. Be nice, pay attention, and be there for each other. With that, I'd like to ask everyone to raise a glass and toast Evan and Hayden. Cheers, cheers. And now Olivia, the maid of honor.
Hey, dude. I love you guys. Okay, so a few months ago, Hayden and I got a couples massage. I'm not going to explain that. We were waiting for our appointment, drinking tea, when Hayden said, "If you told me 6 years ago that I'd be getting a couples massage with my sophomore year roommate, I'd laugh in your face." Hayden and I weren't always naturally friends. In fact, for the entire first semester that we lived together, Hayden and I literally did not talk. We'd say hey in the morning while brushing our teeth, or a see you later on our way out to class. Sorry, I mean on my way out to class. Hayden didn't really go to class. We just didn't talk. She was scared of me because I'd get up at 6 a.m., come back to our dorm around noon while she was still getting ready to microwave her oatmeal with a messy side ponytail, probably wearing Christmas pajamas in peak summer weather. But just like her morning oatmeal, we warmed up. I think the best parts of me have grown from knowing Hayden. My energy to explore, have fun, have a disdain for authority figures, and savor every moment came after I met her. Hayden, you have put me in a lot of wild situations over the years, like running across Avalon in the middle of the night, getting kicked out of bars before reaching the door because skipping is obviously a quicker mode of transportation. Meeting you in college was the most dangerous and best thing I could have ever done. I have a handful of best friends that feel like family, and I met all of them through Hayden. She was the first, and Evett was the second. My first impression of Evett was, man, this guy snores loud. All of his roommates are screaming right now. But Evett quickly became one of my best friends. He's like a brother to me. He's protective of my heart if a guy ever tries to mess with me, but also not afraid to launch me off of an air mattress so high that I nearly break a rib. He's so supportive, loving, and genuinely kind, unless he's tripping me in the parking garage on the way to a concert. Don't worry, Evett, I should be able to run again in a few months. When they first met, Hayden gave Evett an eclair for his birthday. Eclair in French actually means flash of lightning, and I think this is really fitting for their love story. Their love happened in a flash that neither of them expected. I talked to Evett about this moment, and he said that after it happened, his first thought was, wow, who the heck is this girl that would do this for me? She is so genuinely kind and wanted me to feel celebrated. He went on to say that one of the most beautiful parts of Hayden is that she feels people's feelings so deeply. She tries to create moments that you'll remember for the rest of your life. With all that to say, Hayden and Evett, you are both my people. You are my forever roomies. You both have this ability to care so deeply for the people that are in your presence. The love that you have for each other is raw and real, and it's the true love that I've witnessed from the first day I met you in Tower sophomore year. I promise to support you and pray for you and love you always, because we're family and I wouldn't have it any other way. So cheers to a lifetime of unexpected adventures, breakfast burritos, 6-bottle wine deals, and moments to remember forever. And now I would like to introduce the best man.
Mowage. Mowage is what brings us together today. Okay, had to get that out of the way. Actually, what brings us together today is an eclair, a little gesture of kindness from an ambitious girl who graduated high school early and moved to LA to an excited boy starting college the day of his 18th birthday. 1/2 cup of water. It is such a blessing to be here with all of my family, all of the friends who feel like family, and all of the new family I gained here today. I could not be more proud or grateful of a little brother. I'm proud of Evett for all he has achieved,
I'm really proud. I'm proud of Evett for all he has achieved, all the adversity he has overcome, all the success he has found, and all of the challenges he will solve. And grateful that he will journey through life side by side with Hayden, the most wonderful sister-in-law I could ask for. Half a cup of whole milk. For those of you who I've not yet met, my name is Curtis. I am Evett's younger brother, and by his own admission, the best man. I was so excited when he asked me to be his best man that I began writing my speech on June 27th, 2021. Which, if you know us Salingers, is the earliest anyone has ever started an assignment. That being said, I did make my last edits last night at 11:59 p.m. So, yeah. Oh, I did it. We were laying next to each other in bed, and I was editing my speech. Yeah. 8 tablespoons unsalted butter. I've spent my entire life looking up to Evett, both literally, since he is just a few hairs taller than I am, and as a role model. Although I should mention, if his hair was curly like mine, as he wished, maybe we'd be the same height. Anyhow. Evett was a trailblazer, and I was lucky to draft behind him in the race of childhood, learning from his mistakes and being given a preview of what led ahead of me. Sir Isaac Newton said, if I have seen further, it is by standing on the shoulders of giants. And Jacob Carruthers said, follow in the footsteps of your ancestors, for the mind is trained through knowledge. Except in my case with Evett, it was more like, if I have seen further, it is by following in giant footsteps, because Evett's feet are like size 18 and a half or something huge. 1 teaspoon of granulated sugar. He leaves his massive footprints everywhere he goes. I would often be asked growing up if it was hard to grow up under a brother who left big shoes to fill. For me, it was never difficult. It was awe-inspiring. His footsteps showed me what intentionality in life and a sound character, his footsteps showed me that intentionality in life and sound character left others positively impacted for years to come. With my meager size, 11 and a half feet, I've never tried to fill his shoes, but rather do my best to leave the same kind of footprints Evett does. 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Evett's footprints are all over me. When I was in eighth grade, Evett was a junior, and we went to a diner in Durango, and he taught me some calculus in a blue Sharpie on a napkin. He drew some curves, a few lines and column ream on sums, and I had no idea what they were, but I was fascinated. I was so excited to be learning from you, and your excitement from the material was instilled in me. 1 cup all-purpose flour. I remember a few mornings the following year going into school early to sit in our calculus professor or teacher's classroom and looking at a smart board with a polar coordinate grid and a flower on it. I had no idea what I was looking at the time, but you were in fruitful discussion with her about what you were seeing. Your classmates watched as you asked questions they hadn't even thought to ask, and it appeared to me like a dialogue of two teachers. It was inspiring. 4 large eggs. You showed me that being smart was cool. You instilled a desire to push myself harder and go above and beyond in school, and I did just that. Also taking Ms. Haller's classes, loving them, loving to teach them as you did, loving getting 100 on my tests, but I was not without fault. On our first quiz on derivatives, I said 9 - 2 was 7, and Ms. Haller humiliated me in front of the class. At least my humiliation was held in front of the classroom because Evett said that 1 + 1 = 3, and he was humiliated in front of the whole math and physics community by having a paper published in a Harvard math professor naming a whole identity after him. Yeah. Humiliating. Seeing how brilliant you were made me fall in love with academics. I wanted to be smart like you were. I wanted to work hard like you did. And I just graduated as a math major, and you, your excitement for math, and your napkin lessons put me on course. So thank you. 2 cups of whole milk. In many ways, if you look at Evett in my younger years, you will see me hop from footstep to footstep trying to be like him, sometimes only a year behind. He joined theater, I joined theater a year later. He won the Bobby G, I won the Bobby G a year later. He got an internship offer from Northrop, I got an internship offer from Northrop 1 year later. He's getting married this year, and I, well, you're gonna have to wait for that one. 1/2 vanilla bean split lengthwise and scraped. All this established, I hold my brother in very high regard. And so when I learned he'd met a girl in college, I was ready to be critical. I was ready to meet this person whose favorite food was pickles and see what was going on here. Hayden shined in my eyes since day one. From the moment Hayden and Evett started dating, she had tried to get to know me and include me in everything. This meant letting 15-year-old high school me stand around playing guitar while she made an avocado birthday cake at a college party. Some of the roommates are here today. And note that it was not an avocado flavored cake, but it was legitimately an avocado cut in half with a candle in it. 3/4 cup granulated sugar. She came to Durango and they let me tag along as Evett and I showed her our home, which she described as a snow globe type town. She and her family came out to support me when I won my Bobby G in Denver. We've toured LA, we've toured New York, we've toured Scotland together. She helped me move into and out of my senior dorm in college. She has made incredible effort to be present in so many big events in my life and is part of many of my core memories. She truly is family at this point, and I'm so grateful we've made it official today. I cannot wait to make more memories in years to come. 1/4 cup cornstarch. As a little brother and invested spectator, one thing I'm so grateful for is how much joy Hayden brings to Evett. I've seen them have immense amount of fun as a couple, and we all have here today. It's truly admirable how they make joy and create fun wherever they go. What's special is that while they have taken some amazing adventures together, they continue to support and encourage each other on their own independent ventures as well. One pinch of salt. But it doesn't even have to be some picturesque destination. Even with the simple nights in, they can make a go with it. They've gone on camping trips in their backyard, which is not a Colorado joke. They literally camped in the grass behind their house. They've set up an inflatable mattress to have movie nights inside their homes. Whatever and whenever it may be, Hayden and Evett teamwork it to be an amazing time spent together. 4 large egg yolks. In spending time with Hayden and Evett, I have observed compassion, support, adolescent joy, challenge, and true love. During a dinner in New York last year, Evett taking up his fair share of the table, I might add, I watched Hayden lovingly turn towards Evett, and with her full heart, she said, "I just can't wait to marry you and your elbows." Then she said, "Watch this trick," and took a sip of his beer. So that's the other thing I've observed, is a lot of patience. 4 tablespoons unsalted butter. There are so many stories I wish I had time to cover in this speech, such as how Hayden brushed her teeth into a cavity when she and Evett met, how Hayden really wanted a belt sander for Christmas, how Evett kept the ring not hidden in a sock drawer or something in the weeks leading up to the proposal, but in a literal top secret facility, the story of who ate the missing burrito, them putting hot dogs in people's pockets at weddings, which they were gotten back for today. Somebody left a hot dog on their chair. So whoever that was, you're my hero. Going horseback riding and being so sore they almost failed their ballroom dancing final in Argentina, and the list goes on. 4 ounces of semi-sweet chocolate chips. But I'll just end at this. Hayden, it is with so much joy, gratitude, and love that we welcome you into the Salinger and Zabriskie families. Evett, it is with so much joy, gratitude, and love that we see you join Bill and Kathy's families. And both of you, it is with so much joy, love, and gratitude that we see you all beginning to form a family of your own. 1/2 cup heavy whipping cream. The ingredients sprinkled throughout my speech are a recipe for a wonderful and hearty eclair. And the ingredients sprinkled throughout these introductory years of your relationship are a recipe for a wonderful and hearty lifetime together. I love you both so much, and cheers to you.
Good evening. My name is Rebecca Baird, and I'm Hayden's matron of honor. I'm so grateful to be sitting up here tonight with your beautiful family and friends, because not only did I know Hayden and Evett's families would know how to party, but I knew that I would get a front row seat to watch my best friends commit their hearts and lives to each other. I'm so glad that we are here to enjoy this moment, and I just want to thank you both and your families for making this possible. I've known Hayden since we were in sixth grade. It seems like just yesterday we were riding the train at the corn maze, screaming our heads off, or sneaking out of the house at 2 a.m. to go get Sonic and eat cherries and flirt with boys. Sorry, Bill and Kathy. Or go down the stairs in the laundry basket or in the suitcases. Again, sorry, Bill and Kathy. Or get free pie at Village Inn on Wednesdays after riding the bus and getting yelled at by our bus driver, Stella. 15 years has flown by. When we were in middle school, people used to call us twins because we looked so much alike with our long blonde hair. We'd get, "Are they twins?" questions asked of our moms, Kathy and Karen, when we were shopping. And after the 100th time, our moms would sigh and just say yes, because explaining became a chore. But it eventually turned into the truth. Hayden, you are the most selfless, thoughtful, and grace-filled person and friend and our sisterhood has meant so much to me. We have been there for each other through so many moments, good and bad. I have loved watching you grow in your many vocations, especially as a wife, and I've loved our many adventures. But Hayden, of all the adventures I've taken with you, I have to say my favorite has been the grand adventure of watching you fall in love with Evett. The first call Hayden made to me during freshman orientation was about Evett. And from the excitement in her voice, I knew that she had just found the one. Ooh. Weddings always make me cry. I wrote this in my speech. But something about this day has me even more emotional than usual. Maybe it's because Hayden is my best friend, and watching someone you love and cherish and be so happy is the best. I have never seen a human smile and laugh more in the past 6 hours than these two have. Maybe it's because we live hours away and I don't get to see her as much. And though we've grown separately, we haven't grown apart. But maybe it's because I am so happy that I know she has committed her life to a new best friend. One who knows her better than she knows herself. One who will be there to giggle and cry with her after a late night at work. One who will encourage her and support her through every tough decision. One who will tell her her cooking is perfect, even though it sucks. I'm just kidding. Hayden's getting really good at cooking. One who will carry her heart with gentleness and forgiveness and passion that only her true soulmate could do. We may have a front row seat to your love today, but there is a man, another best friend, who will have a front row seat for life. And Hayden, I could not think of a better person to have that role than Evett. Evett, you are Hayden's soulmate. If you want to truly understand who Evett is and you don't know him very well, just think of a golden retriever. That's Evett. Evett, you are hilarious. You're loving, you're creative, you're passionate about justice and love, you're multi-talented, and on top of all of that, you are the perfect man for Hayden. You're completely in love with her, and it's obvious from the tears you shed today and made us all shed at the ceremony. It's obvious from the way you look at her to your grand romantic gestures you so often manage to pull off. You make her laugh, and you catch her when she falls. You would lasso down the moon for her time and time again if she said the words. And Evett, you just get her. I have no doubt that God put you two together, and no doubt that you will spend the rest of your life cherishing and loving this clumsy, goofy, brilliant, and beautiful woman with all your might. So everyone, raise your glasses one last time. Here's to the happy couple, Hayden and Evett. May you grow in love, grow in grace, and never forget this perfect day. I love you both so much. Cheers.
I have one more quick thing to say. Hayden. Can I have this dance?
Thank you.
She'll change her name today. She'll make a promise and I'll give her away. Standing in the bride room, just staring at her. She asked me what I'm thinking and I said I'm not sure.
May your feet always